Center of the San Francisco Zen Center has deemed Watts a great Thoeden prospect. However, critics have dismissed Watts as nothing more than a hippie or a mystic. Watts has labeled himself as a Brahmin, a disreputable Epicurean, and possibly his favorite label, philosophical entertainer. But beyond these labels, Alan Watts may be best described as an interpreter of Eastern wisdom for the Western audience.
A red day!
I don't mean to go through an entire biography of Watts. If you are interested in that, I would suggest an autobiography in my own way. So Watts was born in England in 1915, but he spent most of his adult life in the United States. Despite attending a devout Christian boarding school, Watts gained a fascination of Buddhism at a young age. Following his basic education, he focused on studying and writing about Zen Buddhism until shortly after moving to the U.S. in 1938, where he received a master's in theology from the Christian world. During this time, he attempted to combine Christian religion with Asian philosophy, and in 1945, he was ordained as an Episcopal priest. A year after resigning from the ministry in 1950, Watts moved to California to teach Zen Buddhism, Vedanta, and morals at the Academy. At the American Academy of Asian Studies. However, it lost time, and in fact, he didn't last very long, as he spent a couple of years in Vienna, weekly radio broadcasting programs, which focused on Christian topics. For the next few decades, Watts would continue his broadcast, lectures, and writing. He became a notable spiritual figure in counterculture in the 1960s, since the criticism of Watts was a hippie for a mystic. But in 1973, Watts passed away on the street unexpectedly. Despite having passed away over 4 decades ago, Watts' recordings have found a new home for the group, giving more people access to this prolific record than ever before. As a philosophical experience, Watts' recordings were perfect for free video content.